You can think about it as your bank account. So you can get extra jobs and save money, or you can reduce how much money you spend. So we have to do things like groundwater recharge to increase supply, but we also have to reduce demand. As part of the large groundwater project that we have in the Southwest, we're looking at various practices. And one of those is managing our soil to make sure we have healthy soils. And that involves using different types of mulches or cover crops.
So this is a pistachio orchard. These pistachios are 4 years old. The cover crop basically is we're planting plants in the middle of the rows that normally would be kept bare. We don't harvest the crop. We leave the residue to cover the soil so we have more water stored in the soil.
The other benefit of this cover is regulating temperatures. This thick mulch here protects the soil.
We also have a demonstration plot, so we planted half of the orchard to cover crops and the other half we left out to compare water usage, soil health.
I can tell you that we are already seeing some benefits from using cover crops, for example. Just recently from the atmospheric rivers, I looked at satellite images and I could see a very clear difference in soil moisture between the blocks in this orchard that are cover cropped and the block of the orchard that are not cover crops.
What's cool about this site is that we have a direct side-by-side comparison, where we have a tower like this in the cover crop orchard and also in the orchard with bare soils. Basically, everything is the same except for the presence of the cover crop. And so we can really understand how having that cover impacts these flows of water and carbon in this pistachio orchard.
There's a lot of growers that are hesitant to plant cover crops because they believe that it's going to be using up that precious resource. But that's what we're here working with Isaiah to try to find out and measure the actual benefits or maybe loss if the cover crops are using extra water.
There's nothing more important than working on water and food, because everybody eats, everybody needs water to survive, and I really enjoy working with growers to make sure they're adopting climate-smart farming practices that are not only good for the environment, but also good for their economic sustainability.